Hey YouTubers, XylaTakura here. So everybody should remember I did the first part of this game without Within. I did leave it as an option that if you wanted me to continue playing it, to leave a comment. I didn't receive any comments of people wanting me to keep playing it, but I felt interested enough to keep playing it, so you guys are just going to have to kind of deal with it in the nicest way possible. I hope you're enjoying it as much as I am, because I did really, really enjoy reading it last time, and I did enjoy the humour within it. So I'm just going to go straight back into it. So we need to load our save point. So what happened to Vinti last time? She ended up saving that little boy. Well, I helped her save that little boy. So we'll see. We'll see what happens. I believe she was on her way to her job. So let's see what happened. The sky had gone dark by the time I arrived at work. I opened the restaurant door gingerly to avoid making any noise. Stealth mode switched on. They called me Ninja Vinti for a reason. Miss Vinti! The voice of my boss nearly made me jump onto the ceiling fan. Sorry, I'm late! I wanted to explain, but my boss glared at me, and my tongue slurred out a bunch of syllables. My explanation was in there somewhere. Probably. Maybe. I received an earful from my boss, but at least I got to keep my job. Several colleagues shot me frowns for not being here during such a busy period. I assume she works in like a restaurant or cafe or something. In the end, I took all the blame without complaint. Well, at one point, I locked myself inside the toilet and screamed into the bowl. I also might or might have not fantasized about dunking my workmate's head into the toilet. That was for me alone to know, though. At least I earned the paycheck I needed to keep my landlady quiet for another month. As for the month after that, we would see when the time came. All I wanted was to pursue my art, but reality kept pressuring me towards finding a second job. Ooh. On my way home, I spotted a banner of up-and-coming visual novel named Princess Aria. The game had long been hyped on every forum I knew. Amazing art along with a cast of famous voice actors. The writer and composer were big names too. For Princess Aria, I hope I'm pronouncing that right, to have an ad this big, there must be a lot of money put behind the project. The way this banner hung high gave me the sense it was extra important. I still can't read, I apologise. Bright lights shone on the princess's face to impress potential players. Yes, that was what I really needed. If I had a banner like that, no doubt people would line up to buy my calligraphy. I could already imagine how folks would react as I walked along the streets. Hey, I think that was Vinti! Whoa, no way! You mean that famous calligrapher I see on all those banners? Yeah, she must be really good. Maybe we should ask for her autograph. My agent would then step in to speak on my behalf. Please line up in an order every fashion, anyone. Anyone? Anyone, please! No, everyone. How much for an autograph? Shut up and take my money! My agent nodded in response. Autographs are available for $100, thanks. That would be $100, thanks, the game shop's owner said. Princess Aria cost twice what I predicted. If I bought the game, I would have too little left for rent. Blah, blah, blah. I opened my wallet, hoping I might have more cash on hand than I realised. Turned out I had less, actually. I hung my head in the storekeeper's side. His arched eyebrows pressured me into buying a game. I didn't ride three trains to get here. Might as well pick up something. I told the shopkeeper how much money I had and he shook his head. The owner pulled out a different game from under his table. He brushed away the dust on it so I could see the cover. The title read Sunflower War, some visual novel about the battlefield. Copyright 1997, the bottom read. No wonder it seems so cheap. Art by Invert Mouse, whoever the heck that was. The front cover would fit perfectly into a kindergarten classroom. I flipped the case to see what highlighted on the back. This game supported 640 by 480 resolution. Truly the pinnacle of technology. The shopkeeper grimaced. He must have sensed what I wanted to say. No. His stare made my palms stain with sweat. I ended up buying the game. Dealing with folks like that had always been a weakness of mine. Remind me never to visit this store again. I don't know why you went in the first place. Without within. With heavy strides, I returned to my apartment. Zero calligraphy sales, late for work, and with rent topped up by blowing cash on some game I had no interest in. What I really wanted was to play Princess Aria. Forcing myself to suffer anything else would just upset me further. Play or sleep? I suppose we should be sensible and have some sleep. I know that sounds childish, and I'm usually on my laptop till 11 at night, but some people might think that's early. I'm just going to point out, I don't think it's early. Call me a weirdo for wanting sleep, but I like sleep. Sleep it is. Forget it, I only bought Sunflower War out of pressure. After shoving the game into my bin, I crawled into bed. For the next few weeks, I tried over and over to sell my calligraphies, but all of my works remained untouched. Well, aside from the few pedestrians who stepped on them by mistake. Oh, wait, my bad. I did make one sale. Sorry. This one guy said he needed my calligraphy to use as a toilet paper. Oh, Vinty. Oh, it's gone from funny to really, like, sad and... I feel so much sympathy for her. I had zero passion left for calligraphy. In fact, just thinking about it fueled me with anger. This was no longer the career for me. Today, I chose to retire for good. Bad end. Oh, no. Damn it. Really? Well, I suck at life. Apparently my choices are shit. Damn, okay. Right. Plan B, guys. What we're going to do is when I go for my next episode... I know this one's probably a little bit short, but... next episode, we're going to go through the game again and get the good ending. Because I don't really want to have to deal with people telling me I've done shit and I got the bad ending. So we're going to sort this out. So thank you for watching. Like, subscribe, comment, etc. And I will be back with Out Within in the future because I want to get the good ending. So yeah, deal with it, guys. Thanks, everybody. Take care. See you soon.